Thank you. keep working and doing that calls you to the Lord. Whatever you're trying to say, keep teaching. Victory is made the things that are alive that hinder us from telling the story that God wants us to tell. There are things that get in the way, obstacles, sin that can carry us forward. Victory is our time to stop. There was a new time to stop. Let me encourage you to do that. If that's too long, you place that during the fear, that habit, whatever it was you're trying to stop, you place that in the hands of Jesus to protect and to remove it from our life. Don't do that. Leave it there. Cancel the problem. Keep all our teachers and your praise to the kingdom of the kingdom of the Lord. Last week we talked about the kingdom of the Lord. So it's all your life. The right thing to do is to stay. It will go easier to go. But you pray that God can give you peace and patience to do so. To make your own decisions. To do it. So we're talking about the word today. It's different to today when it would be easier to study. The story from Genesis chapter 12, the story of Abraham and Sarah, one of the great stories in the New Testament. The most familiar stories. God appears to Abraham in Genesis chapter 12. He simply says to Abraham, I want you to leave with me. I want you to go. I want you to leave behind what you have made your entire life. To leave behind what's comfortable, what's promoted. And I want you to go to the land I have chosen. Go to where he's going. I don't know all my prayers. I want you to go to the land I have chosen. Some of you have set up a like that. Not knowing where you're going. Not knowing exactly where you're going to be. Maybe you've been a pilot. And you've got to go to the technology you want to do. We like to know where we're going. We like to know to do like to have contingencies. I want you to leave the land you know. I want you to leave your home, to take your family, all of your possessions, all of your people, and go to the land that I have chosen. That's what you're going to do. We look at everybody's life. The greatest example of faith for the land. He was the man, and Sarah was the woman, and he looked to us a great example of faith. And that faith is evident in the hearing God's call to go. And the Bible simply tells you, they went. Genesis chapter 12 says, Abram went as the Lord had told him. God has made a blessing and a mercy of his nation, but you have to do what you have to do. And Abraham trusted. He trusted in God's promises. He had faith that God would do what God promised to do. Can you imagine if Abraham stayed? Can you imagine stories about if Abraham did not go? We know what happened to him. Because Abraham was faithful. Because Abraham went, God blessed him, and his descendants became numerous as the stars of the sky, and the years of heaven are far ahead. You and I have been blessed. It is Abraham to be blessed. What have you left done? What have you discovered? blessing in this time. If we come and work together, He promises that we will never realize if we come not to be. It's a question we can ask of God each week. The question is, what does God want you to do? Does God want you to walk? If we bless sacrifice in the state, if we don't want to walk in the world, what is the second thing that you will need to take? I tell the story that I want you to tell, but to live the story that I want you to tell, what sacrifice do you need to take? When I was a sophomore, I went to the interview at Methodist prayer today, and they looked at me and said, "Do you have any questions for me?" The majority ones, the ones that I've never heard, said, "Thank you for coming. Thank you for your energy. I need to do that." And I know you're a teacher. I learned from you. What about
those who have died to be called to the name of the Lord. And I open the doors. And God gave me faith. And we have been so loving you. And we have all these things. And the most important thing of all, I want you to be with me. And God will provide the people who do know it. Let them know. And with the help of your God, Spirit, to call you go to the land of your presence. Abraham was faithful. Abraham was great. Knowing where he was headed, that there was a way to go. Abraham didn't have to have enough time to face the journey. All God has to do is to make up faith to start the journey. Thank you. You don't have to keep all the empty. There's no doubt. There is just plenty of people that have to have the faith to face what God has called you to do. Just as a person to take the first step. And maybe God's love, faith on your heart.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you. Thank you.